She is an actress, comedian, and now author. Arden Myrin is here to tell us all about her new memoir, Little Miss Little Compton. Hi, Arden. Good morning.
Hi. Nice to see you. How are you?
I love the cover of your book. Now, I have to ask you, now, when you're talking about Compton, you're not talking about Compton here in Los Angeles, right?
No, I grew up in a town called Little Compton. It's in Rhode Island. It is truly the smallest town in America, and it has a general store and no stoplights and a lot of fishermen. So, yes, it's a tiny, tiny Compton.
And now that you're in this business, but yet you grew up in this tiny town, it's kind of like a little fish out of water story. Can you tell us what were the things that surprised you most about living and working in LA and Hollywood?
I mean, it was such a difference. People who've read my book say that it feels like they're watching Schitt's Creek, but they're reading it. So just like a resident, you know, that's been hanging out with Dan Levy, all of a sudden moving to Hollywood, I couldn't find my way around Los Angeles. I mean, the fact that there was a large Santa Monica Boulevard and then a little Santa Monica Boulevard and stoplights. I mean, all of it was just a whole journey for me.
I hear you on the Santa Monica Boulevards. I remember that so much. Now, you got your start as an intern at Conan O'Brien. His interns tend to be very successful in comedy, but you said you weren't doing a whole lot of comedy when you were interning there, right?
I was an intern at Conan O'Brien, and I was working the copy machine quite a bit. I was actually way too good at getting the jam out. I knew all the guys that worked at Xerox that would come in. But it was really cool to see how a TV show was put together. I mean, I certainly didn't grow up with any connections. And I would recommend to anybody to work behind the scenes just so you understand what everybody's job is. And that was, you know, my first big job in Hollywood. And so it was really thrilling a few years later when I got to go back on as a guest was, you know, that's partially why I called it Little Miss Little Compton, because I felt like Little Miss Sunshine. Like,
aww.
Yeah, I always had these stars in my eyes, but I grew up in a field with, you know, 3,000 people in the whole town. And I never thought that would happen. You know, we had the town criminal. Did you know that stealing mail is a federal crime, Dana?
I did. I did know that, actually. Didn't do that, right?
I didn't do that, but there was a person, people were stealing mail in my town and nobody could figure out who it was. The mail kept going missing. And then they figured out that this woman had a local pet. She kept a crow as a pet, and his name was Poe the Crow. And Poe the Crow would fly around and like learn how to open people's mailboxes and would steal the mail and fly off. And it was like they actually had to like prosecute Poe, and he became an indoor crow. He was on like house arrest. He was an indoor crow for the rest of his life.
You know, I'm sure we're probably running out of time, but I have to ask you really quickly. So you're from this small town. You get to be on Friends, right?
Yeah.
Here you are on an episode of Friends.
Yeah.
And then kind of the unthinkable happens. Can you tell us quickly about that?
There I am. I act as a guest star on Friends. There I am in Monica's apartment with Courtney Cox, America's sweetheart. And during rehearsals, I accidentally, Dana, kicked Courtney Cox in the face. Right there. So she ran to rehearse this. And I had all the buckets. I had like the chunky early aughts boots on. And right there, during rehearsal, fully kicked her in the face. And I write about that in the book. There was a moment like I was in the Matrix, like, oh my God, Courtney Cox, please be cool. She'll always be my favorite friend. She spared me. She couldn't have been sweeter. But like, there was a moment as like a young actress, you're like, I literally kicked America's sweetheart in the face.
Yeah, and you're like, I'm never going to work again. Right.
I'm never going to work again. I'm out of here.
And yeah. Give us a summary of your podcast, Will You Accept the Rose? Specifically, I think you're talking about feeling thorny.
Oh, okay. Well, I have a podcast called Will You Accept This Rose? We break down episodes of The Bachelor. And when it's off season, we do things that are a little more one-on-one called Feeling Thorny, where we sort of get intimate with people and get to know their lives. But it's truly, I talk with comedians about, you know, watching these bodybuilders and dental hygienists looking for love. And it's a comedy podcast on iHeartRadio. We have all, you know, Thomas Middleditch has done it from Silicon Valley, Rob Benedict from Supernatural. All these fun people come and we break down episodes of The Bachelor and we're super fans and it's a joy.
Okay, first of all, you get an award for best titles. Like, first of all, Little Miss Little Compton, brilliant. Feeling
Thank
Thorny,
you.
Brilliant. Will You Accept yes. This Rose, so good. Your naming skills are off the charts.
Thank you so much.
You're so welcome.
I'm available for baby naming.
Oh, good, good. Arden, it was such a joy to have you on. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
You're
Come
so
back
welcome.
Tomorrow.
And your book looks beautiful. Little Miss Little Compton is available September 29th, wherever you buy books. Thank you. Back to you guys.
All right.